Hey guys, it's Dominika, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna answer some of your questions about Denmark, studying in Denmark that you sent to me. So basically, last year I did this vlog where I put as one of the things in the title, studying in Denmark, and I received few private emails from you guys asking many questions. So I figured why I won't make a video about it. A little bit of a background. I study in Denmark for 4.5 years now. I am on my master's right now and I did my entire studying experience in Denmark, so maybe it's a little bit hard for me to compare it to universities in other countries since Denmark is kind of all that I know technically, but I'm still gonna try to answer your questions the best of my ability. And another thing is that I did my bachelor in economics and business administration and and I'm doing right now my master's for marketing. And as always, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss more Denmark related videos, you know. So the first question, which university to choose? And the answer to that is kind of more complicated than you would think of when it comes to the best universities in Denmark. In Copenhagen, University of Copenhagen, there's also CBS, Copenhagen Business School. Then in Aarhus, the university that I'm at, Aarhus University, there's Aalborg University and South of Denmark University. And those are like the top of mind, the best schools sort of on the ranking. However, it's a little bit more complicated than that because it depends a little bit on what you want. So I've started my study journey from Academy, which is University of Applied Sciences. Sciences, yes. And then I transferred to Aarhus University because it depends a little bit on what you want out of a study experience. So I did my AP degree, Academy Professional Degree, at the Academy, so University of Applied Sciences, and that school's universities of applied sciences are not in rankings pretty much because they are not research universities. So they are great for people who want to get good knowledge from their field and then go straight to work. So during my 2-year program, marketing management, did I already say that? Academy professional degree in marketing management, Jesus Christ, oh. So during that program, pretty much everything was about the group work and the casework. During the first year, I believe you wrote 5 or 6 group projects. So when we had one chapter, we'd receive a company case. Sometimes it would be a real company actually coming to us. Sometimes it would be like made up company or company that, you know, we choose. And we would write a group project about it, solving their issues based on the knowledge from the course that we just learned. So it was super, super practical. Also exams were really practical. We had one exam per semester combining all the subjects, and part of that course was also obligatory internship, which is really good on your CV. That's what I recommend for you if you just want to get a really good knowledge, go to work and you don't care about university being high in ranking and that stuff. Then definitely University of Applied Sciences Academies is definitely a way to go for you. To me, I really enjoyed my time in the academy. I think I really learned a lot during that time, but I really want to also have this proper university experience. Academy, there was 30 of us in a group talking, so it felt a little bit more like high school still, but more, you know, on their professional level. And I really wanted to have that university experience, you know, sit in an auditorium of like 200 people and you have separate subjects and you have exam from each of the subjects. I really wanted to have that experience, and I also wanted to do my master's degree. Another thing is that if you go to University of Applied Sciences, first do AP degree, usually 2 years, and then you go for a top-up, which is 1.5 years, and then Universities of Applied Sciences don't offer you master's degrees, so you have an option usually to go to master's degrees at university, but it's kind of harder to get in from the academy than if you go already from the university. That's why also I transferred to university later on, and I transferred to university kind of as a top-up, and then I went to master's right now. But if you graduate like bachelor in economics and business administration, then you have automatic right to go to master's in economics and business administration, and the university had like 10 or something like that master's underneath that, and I chose marketing. And you can use that right only once, so I chose it once. So for example, now if I wanted to switch my master's, I wouldn't have that guarantee spot anymore. So it's a little bit more complicated, and I maybe went a little bit off topic, but this is sort of the things you need to look at when you choose. So to sum up, universities of applied sciences, also referred to as academies, they are very, very practical, lots of group work, obligatory internships, atmosphere is very cozy as there's usually only 30 of you in a group, however they don't exist in the rankings, and and they don't offer any master's programs, so you have to switch to uni anyways if you want to do them. And regular universities, they give you traditional university experience, there's more focus on research, they are higher in rankings, you can automatically go to master's in the same study line. However, you are in auditorium with 100 other people, so professor doesn't really know your name, so it's far less personal and you're a number. And another question was which program to choose. So there is this website that I really recommend for you, Master's Portal, I think that's what it's called. You can see it right now over here. So you can choose country, but also like the program, field, tuition and stuff. So I really recommend you guys browsing for that website, looking for what you want, and then going to university's webpage. Then how to apply. So in general, every university will tell you exactly kind of what they want you to do, and you can apply directly to university. And then you have to do by yourself like the language certificate. I think it's TOEFL, IELTS. I don't exactly know, but you can read about that when you choose like the specific subject that you want. However, what I did is, because I started from the academy in Poland where I come from, there are special organizations that help you apply to the academies. So I went there for an English test, and it wasn't the official test, it was a test organized by the agency where they just want to see if I speak English basically, and they also helped me with the paperwork. So they asked me, okay, send us this and that. So that was really helpful. And if you're going to your academy, I don't think they do that with universities, but maybe they do, definitely look at the organizations in your country, especially that it's for free for you usually. Like for me, it was for free because it's the university who paid that organizations for each student that goes to their school. So definitely look at those organizations in your country, but if you don't have that option, go straight to university that you chose. Now moving on from sort of more practical questions into more like daily life. How is the daily student life? I think, you know, it's a lot of fun. I mean, right now with the corona and everything, obviously it's a little bit different, but in general, I think Denmark is a really good place to study because universities are really concentrated on students. They really want to give you the best program possible. There are constant evaluations and all of that stuff because they really want to make sure that you get the most out of the program, because then you also write better reviews for the program. So it's like a whole circle. So in general, like daily student life, I feel like it's much more relaxed than it would be in other countries. And I think in general, school and teachers respect you more as a student because they really want to make sure that they're doing a good job. So I feel like in general, like I'm recommending Denmark overall to study because it was, I think, one of the best decisions of my life clearly. And even though it's been, what, 4.5 years now, when I look back, I don't see better options for myself. I still don't think I would have done anything, you know, differently. P.S. 3 of my classmates chose to study in the UK. I chose Denmark because I didn't want to graduate with £21,000 debt, and studying in Denmark is free for me as I am an EU citizen. Additionally, when you get a student job, you receive a grant from the government that you don't have to give back. However, finding a job is not that easy and it takes a while. How much time do you study, like prepare for class, homework and all of that? So in general, what you're expected is that if you're a daily full-time student, it's sort of your full-time job, so you're expected to spend 8 hours 5 days a week. And if you want to get the best grades, it's probably what you have to do. You have to do every sort of all the readings, prepare for classes, and you know, repeat stuff before the exam. But if you're a student like me, which is sort of average, then I don't spend that much time studying. I also have part-time job, so I usually go there 2 days a week or day and a half, so that time is sort of gone. Overall, I feel like 8 hours for 5 days is sort of a safe estimate of how much time you need to prepare, but then in the exam period things get more hectic. Small clarification, I do study, but mainly during the exam period, where I do all the readings within 2 weeks instead of doing them throughout the semester, which results in me getting an average grade. And when it comes to how much it takes to prepare for class, schools in Denmark have 30 ECTS per semester. We had usually either 3 10 ECTS courses each, or we had 2 10 ECTS courses and 2 5 ECTS courses. It's usually spread like that. So then in general, 10 ECTS points classes, you have 2 lectures per week, and 5 ECTS, you have 1 lecture per week. And on a bachelor, they would usually give us like 1 chapter from book to read per lecture, which is not crazy amount. Then we also had separate classes which were tutorials. So then they would give us usually 5 7 exercises to make prior to class and then come to class and sort of ask questions about the stuff that you don't understand. And then right now on my master's, I can see there's more reading. So we usually right now have a book chapter and then we have one or two academic articles to read. Sometimes we have only two or three academic articles to read, and then some of them are 10 pages, some of them are 20. So it's definitely much more academical on your master's, but I still don't think it's that bad. Like, it's, they still don't flood you with crazy amount of readings comparing to, like, I know in Poland, they, you know, you study all the time. In Denmark, it's not like that. The point is that they're supposed to give you the essential knowledge, not to bombard you with unnecessary pages. How involved are students and professors? So overall, it's hard to say how involved they are. It's more a thing about the atmosphere in the class. So you address professors on a first name basis, which to me was a shock coming from Poland. How can you say to, like, the guy who's 50, you know, like, John, like,
what?
But you call them on a first name basis, you have their email addresses, so you have a right to email them, and different professors are different. We had some of them which were like,
whenever you have a question, please email me, there's my office, you can come by.
And then there were some which were more like,
if you really have to, you can send me a question, but kind of leave me alone.
So it kind of depends, but in general, the teachers are much more welcoming. None of them will ever raise their voice on you or be upset that you ask something, no. Some of them might be a little bit more, okay, I'm at home, I'm not answering emails, I'll do it in the office in 5 days. But in general, I'd say that the study environment is much more friendlier, professors are much more friendlier. We have evaluation in the middle of the course and we have evaluation after the course. I'm part of the student board, so every end of the semester we have a meeting with secretaries, people organizing, like, the course structure and everything, who are also in charge of, like, professors technically. So we give them, like, our input, what we liked, what we disliked. So if you're starting a new program, there might be some hiccups, but if it's a program that's well established, they did so many evaluations over time that they pretty much know what they're doing. Now with Corona, things have been different because suddenly we have online classes, online exams, so the new issues kind of came from that. But in general, I'd say the professors are very nice. They definitely want you to ask questions. Also in the lectures at the end, they ask if you have any questions, and they like questions overall, I'd say. Yeah, okay, the next question was, how is the academic environment, and I kind of just explained that, but I'd say, like, overall Denmark, it's very relaxed country to study, trust me. I think my middle school in Poland was more stressful than university in Denmark. So if you're thinking about Denmark, I highly, highly recommend it. I don't think you'd be disappointed. In general, when I talk about people, some of them are maybe a little bit disappointed by other stuff with Denmark when it comes to non-study related things, like people, finding a job, yada yada. However, when it comes to actual university in Denmark, I don't. I think I've met people who are really disappointed in that. So I think that's everything for today. I know this video has been kind of rumbly. I just talked, but people who come here to watch this video hopefully wanted me to just talk about stuff. If you have any more questions, you can write that in the comment field below, or also my email is in the description below, so you can also email me questions and I can do part 2 of this video. And again, you know, like it if you liked it, because then if you like the videos, I know that you want me to make more of them, so you know, it's more likely the next one is coming. And for now, I hope you have a very, very wonderful day, and thank you so much for watching. Bye bye. Old folks talking about back in my day, but homie, this is my day. Class started 2 hours ago. Oh, am I late? No, I already graduated, and you can live through anything if magic made it. They say I talk with so much.